Okay, so today I'm working on my Toyota Corolla A86, and I am working on the transmission because I am having some problems shifting from first to second and from third to second. So I'll be removing the transmission, and to do that I have got my manual, as you can find somewhere in the internet, I don't know, but it's something like this, and I am following the chapter that talks about removing the transmission. First thing you need to do is to remove the negative battery terminal, and then remove the inside of the console. This is what I am going to do now. So now I'll be removing the the lever, the shift lever. You start by unscrewing the top like so. My lever is a bit different because I bought it aftermarket. Yours doesn't have to look like this. So take it off like so. Then you have to let me grab a light here. As you can see, I've already got my car safely raised using jack stands, and just for safety precaution I got some bricks and set them under the tires all around for added safety, because in these kind of situations, better safe than sorry. I'll get the light here. Start by finding a place to put my lighter. Well, let's say like this. So you have to remove the console. First thing you have to do is pull this plastic cover out and remove this this screw. Yours may have two screws, but you know, this car is 25 years old, so so I'm now unscrewing this first screw. I got myself a plastic container from those assorted cookies, you know, and this is very useful for placing your, for organizing your screws. So that you know which screws go into which holes when you assemble again. So now we have to remove another screw here on the side. Oops. There should be another screw in the same place on the dash. Oh, there are two more screws on the top here near the glove box. You can see. Remove this. It's already loose. Remove this and place it in your tray. Do the same on the other. After removing these four screws, you can pull the console off like so. And to the back it goes. Now, to continue on with your disassembly, let me put a little more light here. Continue on with this assembly. You have to remove a screw here, and there should be another one on the side, like so, here. After removing those two screws, you... this light is a pain in the ass. So, after removing those screws, it is loose now. So you pull the rubber inside and pull the plastic out, like so. After a little bit of force in the beginning, it starts to come off. Quite simple, like so. Put it in the back. And now you have to remove four screws, one at each side of each corner of the protector. So the screws are off, and off comes the protective shroud. Now you have to remove the lever itself, like so. There are another four screws you have to remove, and the whole assembly will come out. Like so. We have four screws you have to remove around the assembly. Do not try to remove this rubber, because it's there forever. So just stick with it. You have to remove the screws around, moving the the rubber around. Okay, you remove the four screws, and you can also see the shaft that goes to the gearbox, and there should be a bushing here, and well, I have worked previously on this, so I put some grease here, but maybe I'll replace it with this, with the lithium grease. I didn't know at the time that it wasn't a proper way of lubricating rubber joints, so maybe I'll clean this up and place here some lithium grease, maybe. So now this we can see here is the gearbox itself, so we're ready to proceed to the next step. Now I'll put some food wrap over this gasket, just to make sure that no dirt goes in. It's not perfect, but does the job.